Hello, my name is Ruffin, and in this short demo, we'll go over how to use Docker as a tool to build and share ROS development environments. First, we'll start off by running an interactive shell session within the ROS container using the Docker engine. Then we'll install some basic build essentials and create and initialize a catkin workspace. Inside our new workspace, we'll clone the ROS tutorials package and build from source. We'll ignore the turtle sim for now, as it requires some additional dependencies. Note, there is no other dependency requirement other than a Docker installation on the host machine. In fact, the demo could be performed on any modern Linux distro, not only Ubuntu. Okay, let's add our catkin workspace setup to the entry point, so we can easily launch our compiled binaries later. Then, we can commit the current state of our container to an image for later use. This takes a difference of how the container has changed as compared to its derived image and adds a new layer. Then, we can see the image listed among those stored locally within the Docker engine. If we introspect even further, and examine the finer details of our image history, notable information can be viewed, such as the time the image was built, the parent image and container pair it was built from, the list of network ports exposed, environmental variables defined, the default entry point for runtime commands, as well as any committed comments. Now let's switch over to the networking aspects of distributing multiple nodes across Docker containers. If we want all our ROS nodes to easily talk to each other, we can use a virtual network to connect to separate containers. The same level of networking is also possible across separate hosts, and will be addressed in a later demo for Docker Swarm. Now that we have a network, we can create services to attach to it. Services advertise themselves on the network, keeping it simple to resolve the location and address of the service-specific container. We'll use this to make sure our ROS nodes can find and connect to our ROS master. Now that the ROS master is up and running, we'll add the talker and listener nodes as services on the common network. Note the relevant environmental variables used to define the master node's hostname in terms of the service names published. All right. Now we see the listeners echoing the messages broadcasted by the talker node. Let's list the services created by the respective containers. Here we see the status list of our containers created just seconds ago, as well as their entry point commands and unique IDs. Okay, now that we see the two nodes are communicating, let's get inside one of the containers and simply find what exact topics are being exchanged. Once inside with the environment set, we can run additional ROS commands to query the list of topics, detail pub/sub graphs, tune any ROS parameters, and etc. In summary, we created a working ROS development environment on a host with only Docker installed. Then, we created a new image encapsulating our ROS application to share with our colleagues. Afterward, we deployed our app onto a distributed set of Linux containers interconnected via a virtual network, ready to be abstracted to multiple machines or robots. Thank you for watching.